Welcome back from the courthouse to the campaign trail. Donald Trump spent the day yesterday defending himself in front of a judge before attending a fundraising event in his next White House run.
The question now is whether the former US president can avoid running his campaign from prison. Let's bring in former White House official Laura Schwartz in Chicago. As always, Laura, so good to see you. Now, it's amazing how quickly Donald Trump switched from defendant to candidate, although we wouldn't put it past him, of course.
No, I mean, that's where he's most comfortable, being a candidate and being president, because it's about the brand. It's about the persona. In fact, his staff were pretty relaxed last night over at Bedminster, New Jersey, because they say they've got this playbook down. You know, there might be one or two more indictments still coming during the during the primary campaign for the Republicans. But they thought that showing the visual yesterday, as we're seeing there at the Cuban restaurant, and then a rally last night in front of his donors. Now, he not only raised $2 million plus last night, but we hear he was walking around, wining and dining people. He even took the iPad over and played the DJ for a while behind the scenes at Bedminster for that dinner. So he's feeling pretty confident. He sees that this is just emboldening him among his Republican base.
Laura, our Prime Minister here was famed for DJing as well, so taking a leaf out of his book. You've organised events as a career. The timing is going to be tricky, though, right? Because there's going to be trials, and chances are he'll be in and out of court throughout the campaign.
You're right, Charles. And in federal court, he needs to be there as the defendant. In civil court, just about a month ago, he didn't have to be there for a separate case. He would have to be there sitting there in front of the judge and the jury the entire time. Now, Southern Florida is known for what's called a rocket docket. It's fast moving when it comes to federal criminal cases. But Trump's team, they wanted to delay, delay, delay. I mean, they want to try to have this delayed till even after the general election. So a lot of pretrial motions will be made. It may be a favorable judge to the Trump team, but we won't know that schedule until a few weeks from now.
Now, Laura, we know that Donald Trump is already using this to boost his campaign. He certainly galvanized his base. But has there been any kind of negative fallout?
You know, a few senators up on Capitol Hill who are in safe states and a few House members in safe districts have said, you know, this just isn't right if what's in this indictment is true. You've seen maybe two candidates that are running 1% and 2% in the polls among the Republicans come out swinging against him. I think we'll see a lot more just seeing how serious this goes throughout the summer, as well as if he's indicted in Georgia for asking for those 11,780 votes by the phone, and the January 6th insurrection case that's still ongoing right now. In fact, the grand jury was seated in Washington yesterday, hearing testimony from witnesses that would be a part of that January 6th insurrection indictment. So it's interesting to see what might come about for him.
Laura, you mentioned the polls. Where does Donald Trump sit right now?
Right now, he's done nothing but solidify his base. This has not rocked them. In fact, he even gets more support among Republicans when he frames this as a political motive. Even though this investigation and the fight with the National Archives was going on long before he announced his candidacy for 2024, but when he frames it like a political motivated, process and election interference, it's good for him among more than just his base. But this man is solid right now in the Republican. He's 30 points ahead of DeSantis in Florida. He's 47 points ahead of his former Vice President Mike Pence. And as far as Biden goes, it's relatively the same. Prior to indictment, Biden led 46-44. Post-indictment, 48-44. So we'll have to wait and see how this shakes out in the states.
Long way to run.
Yeah. All right, Laura, thanks so much for that insight. Appreciate it, as always.